Today, I'll be sharing my favorite easy homemade winter moisturizer for dry skin. And yep, it's all natural. Stick around. Hey, I'm Tamatha Lane, indie artist, health enthusiast, and a new mom. And I post videos on health, detox, and mommyhood. So if any of these things interest you, please do subscribe and hit the notifications bell. I just want to mention to stay tuned and make sure to subscribe and hit the notifications bell for an upcoming series I have featuring detox specialist Eileen Duran. I'll be posting the first video in this series next week, so keep an eye out for that. We'll be answering all of your questions I've received by direct message or in the comments regarding diabetes, cancer, infertility, anxiety, depression, skin issues, autoimmune diseases. This will be a masterclass on detoxification and herbal protocols, the right diets and foods to eat for your specific needs. Eileen will be answering all of these questions. She's also used detox to heal herself from the debilitating autoimmune disease fibromyalgia. So she's speaking from experience of healing herself and also helping hundreds of other people to heal. So definitely stay tuned, subscribe, hit the notifications bell for that series coming up of Detox Masterclass with Eileen Duran. And also let me know if there's any other topics that you'd like me to cover with Eileen. I've been on a detox journey for a while now, and my husband, my parents, and even my one-year-old daughter have all begun to eat an alkaline diet and to use herbs to heal and to detox. And I document all of our results here on this channel, so make sure to subscribe for updates on our results. And also, I'll link the other videos, like my mom's results using Dr. Sabi's advanced detox package, my dad's results lowering his blood pressure in 3 days by eating an alkaline detox diet. All of those videos, I'll link them below. So make sure to check them out after this video. So let's dive right into today's video, my non-toxic, easy homemade winter moisturizer for dry skin. My skin has been painfully dry this winter, and I've been moisturizing with just plain coconut oil, but it just has not been working, okay? Not lately. No matter how much pure coconut oil I would apply to my skin, it was still dry, and it was just itchy and really tight feeling and very uncomfortable. So I knew that something had to change. And since I've been detoxing, I know how important it is to make sure that what I'm putting on my skin is pure and not filled with toxins and chemicals. So I knew that I was going to have to figure out a DIY cream to make. And I searched online. I saw some decent recipes, but they all involve using a blender or a mixer. And ain't nobody got time for that right now. I didn't feel like the cleanup. I just wanted something quick and easy that I could just stir up. And that's what this recipe is. It doesn't involve any mixers, any blenders. It's just you, a couple jars, and a spoon and some oils. Finally, last night, I just couldn't take it anymore. My skin was so dry. I went and gathered up all of the best moisturizing ingredients that I have in the house, and I just made what turned out to be an amazing moisturizer for my super ultra dry skin. The texture of my hands and face changed instantly. I was no longer itching from dry, dehydrated skin, and I actually woke up the next morning with my skin still feeling moisturized. So here is my quick and easy recipe, and just want to let you know that all the links to the products that I mentioned are in the description box below, so you can check them out if you want to replicate this if you don't have some of these oils and some of these moisturizers. And it can also be used for your hair, your face, your feet, your full body. So it's an all-purpose moisturizer, and I am loving it. So let's get right into this recipe. So here's what you'll need: 1/4 cup of 100% pure shea butter, 1/4 cup of organic unrefined coconut oil, and 10 drops of wild orange essential oil. doTERRA is the brand I use because it's therapeutic grade and it's all pure. And also 10 drops of lavender doTERRA essential oil, 10 drops of frankincense doTERRA essential oil, 1 teaspoon of ancient Greek oil, and that actually has 3 different oils in it, which is olive oil, almond oil, and vitamin E oil. And then 1 teaspoon of emu oil and 1 teaspoon of black seed oil. And actually, I would have done 1 tablespoon of emu oil, 1 tablespoon of black seed oil, but I just didn't have that much, so I didn't want to use up too much. But emu oil is really a good oil because it penetrates at the cellular level. Also, the doTERRA essential oils are great because they also penetrate at the cellular level. Shea butter and the coconut oil, they're bigger molecule oils, so they don't necessarily penetrate as deep into the skin. And so I feel like this moisturizer worked really well because I have all of these other oils like emu oil and like the essential oils that really penetrate the cells. And I think mixing those with the pure shea butter and also with the coconut oil really helped to moisturize my skin more than just the coconut oil, which was starting to feel like it was just sitting on top of my skin when I used it alone. The other things that you'll need is mason jar. So I use a 4-ounce mason jar and then also just a regular bowl and a spoon and then some type of a pan or something that you can put hot water in so that you can immerse your coconut oil in it so that it can melt a little bit. The first thing you want to do is take out your 1/4 of a cup of coconut oil and I put it into an 8-ounce mason jar and then I immerse it into a bowl of really, really hot water and let it just kind of liquefy. And then once you have that, you want to take your 1/4 of a cup of shea butter, pour the shea butter, pour the coconut oil all into a bowl. And you want to pour it into a bowl that's big enough to be able to mix these things together without any of them spilling out. So once you have your melted coconut oil and you have your shea butter, you want to mix those together. Then you want to do your 10 drops of essential oils. It will end up being 10 drops of lavender, 10 drops of wild orange. And the frankincense oil, I actually did not have. I was all out of that yesterday. So I don't actually have that included in this oil and it still works well. But if I were to have that, it would, I think, really enhance because frankincense is such a good oil for your skin. So you would add the coconut oil, the shea butter, the essential oils. Then you want to add your 1 teaspoon or 1 tablespoon, which is preferred if you have enough of the black seed oil, and then 1 tablespoon or 1 teaspoon of the emu oil and 1 teaspoon or 1 tablespoon of the ancient Greek oil. And that oil is really great and one of my favorites because it has the 3 oils included within it, like I mentioned before, the olive oil, the almond oil, and also the vitamin E oil. Mix it all together, just stir it up because the coconut oil was so liquidy, it'll be more of a liquid form at first. You'll notice that it has a nice scent because of the wild orange and the lavender, and if you have frankincense, because of the frankincense, it'll have a nice smell. And then what I do is I take that once it's well mixed, I pour that into my 4-ounce mason jar, and I label it. I just took some masking tape and wrote on it moisturizer, put the date on there, put the air top lid on the mason jar, and boom, it was done. And I just carry this moisturizer around with me in my purse so that if I'm feeling really dry throughout the day, my hands are dry, I can put it on. If my neck or my face or anything feels dry or itchy from this dry winter air, I just put it on. You can give or take some of these oils, but this is the combination that I used. And I know that this seems like a lot of oils at first, but they last for a long time. You can make this mixture over and over again. It's an initial investment, but it's worth it in the end. I wish I would have combined these a long time ago because on their own, they work okay, but together, it's been a miracle oil for me. If you want to learn more about detox and just how to live a healthy lifestyle and transitioning into detox, you can watch my video, Dr. Sebi for Beginners. And if detox seems overwhelming, remember that small changes over time will equal big changes in the long run. I share a lot of easy lifestyle tweaks that you can make on the road to detox in my video, Affordable Dr. Sebi Alternatives. So I'll link that below so you can watch it after this video. And make sure to watch my video, Dr. Sebi Meal Plan Ideas, to learn more about the 3 detox diet levels. To learn more about how to detox using an alkaline diet and herbs, watch my series, Detox Made Easy. And you can also watch my series on Dr. Sebi and his herbal products and dietary recommendations for alkaline living. I'll link those videos below. Don't forget to join my Facebook group, Alkaline Living and Detox, for more question and answer and meal plan ideas, and just as a way to surround yourself with a group of like-minded individuals. Please do subscribe, like, and share this video if it was helpful for you and you feel like it could help your friends and your family and all of them. I am Tamatha Lanay. Thanks so much for watching. Take care. God bless. And I will see you in the next video.